Hello, welcome to an episode of Living the Journey. I'm Jenna Guayad-Harris.
And I'm CJ Sanchez.
And today we're here with Miss Marcia Terry.
Hi, everybody.
She's mom, entrepreneur, founder of Viva, a myth, a legend,
yep.
And also a mindset transformer, which
yes.
is what we're here to talk about today. We're going to talk about all things mindset transformation, and who better to have that conversation with than you.
Oh, thank you so much. I'm so excited to be here. I
yes.
love this. You guys are amazing.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm excited. I'm a big fan.
Thank you,
I'm
CJ.
Personally a big fan, and I think that, you know, Jenna's been a big inspiration for my shift in mindset, right? Just not by coaching, but just by being and having somebody mm-hmm. that specializes in that here between both of us. I'm excited to extract whatever magic that you possess, you know, and kind of just bring it to the forefront to a lot of people, because I think that, especially after this past year,
yeah, right.
the mindset reset. It may be very much necessary.
Mindset reset.
Mindset
yes.
reset with the way, I mean, I know I experienced that. I think we all did, right? So
why don't we start with what is a mindset transformer?
Yeah.
Sounds like something you see on the Avengers.
Well, like I wanted to like see.
And I'm a huge Avengers fan, so.
Saving that for another topic, another
yeah.
episode.
Really, I like to call myself a mindset transformer because I think I specialize in helping people understand how their thoughts and their words connect with how they feel.
Mm.
And I think everything that we do starts with how you think.
Mm-hmm.
And how you think, like I've said before, you bring about what you speak about, and so and also what you think about.
Mm-hmm.
So if you have thoughts that are not so positive, then maybe you're not that positive person.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah. Makes sense.
Yeah.
And it's not just about having positive thoughts and thinking positive. It's deeper than that. But I think it starts with definitely how you think.
I can attest to that because I've really made it my work starting, I would say, about a year to 2 years ago of really changing my mindset. And people, I think, look at me and they say, well, you're just always positive. You're just naturally happy, which, yes, I have a little bit of that in me, but also I work at it by sticking post-its mm-hmm. in places that are helpful to me, like in the morning. I have...
On your Peloton.
On my... I just have things everywhere. Like, I'm
yeah.
constantly feeding it to myself.
Yeah.
So I know it's something that doesn't just happen. It's
no.
something that you have to make happen for yourself, right?
Yes, it's a conscious thing that you have to do. So mindset transformation for me is, again, feeding your mind, body, and soul, right? So every day I wake up, I feed my mind in some capacity. And then it helps you just become a better person overall. And it helps you think differently, and then you show up differently, and then you become that positive person that everybody talks about.
Mm-hmm.
But it's because you are taking an interest and an effort in feeding your mind in a different way than most people.
Yeah. I wanted to ask, so how does the mind transformer come to life? You know, what? How did that spark in you that drive or that calling to call yourself that?
So really, it started about 10 years ago.
Okay.
In a really weird kind of way. I was really involved in network marketing
mm-hmm.
and like really involved and had a huge team, whatever. And my coach was amazing, amazing person. And I would listen to the way he would speak to people and be able to take them on this journey through conversation from point A to point B. And not so much to buy into the package, but just transform their thinking and so that they could have dreams and aspirations.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember saying to him, I want to do what you do. And it's not like he went to school for it. I'm like, you have a gift. I want to do that. And so I knew there was something special about that. So he's like, you don't have to go to school. I'm like, I know, but I'm going to go get trained on how to mm-hmm. how to ask the right kind of questions, because that's basically what it is. It's asking the right kind of questions to get the response.
Right.
And the answers are always within, right? Mm-hmm. So that's kind of where it started, is back then. I mean, in network marketing, there's a huge emphasis on personal development. Mm-hmm. I was really drawn into that. And so from there, I went on and I became a certified health and life coach and so on and so forth, and here we are talking about mindset transformation.
you said something a little bit ago about your morning routine,
mm-hmm.
and I think that there is so much power in the morning routine, because, I mean, I do it personally. I know a lot of other successful people that have a very specific morning routine, and when they don't do it, they feel that they're misaligned or that they're not going to produce as much as if they had done the morning
Correct.
Routine. So I want to know two things. I want to know your morning routine, but I also want to know the why. Why does it make such a difference when we do it?
Yes. So morning routine is like, I mean, I think it's a game changer. Mm-hmm. So there was a point in my life where I used to say, I'm not a morning person.
I think a lot of people say that.
I wasn't a morning person. I couldn't get up in the morning. I couldn't do anything. Couldn't function. Like, don't talk to me until after 10 o'clock. Okay. But I changed my language. So in changing my language, changed how I thought about being a morning person. So my morning routine is, since you asked, answer your question. First thing I do when I get up in the morning is I check in with my accountability partners. Mm. And we've been checking in, I want to say, for about 2.5 to 3 years.
We know one of your accountability partners. She's mentioned, she's been on our show and mentioned that she has accountability partners.
These are coming full down.
Oh, wait a minute.
Every day we check in.
Professor, is that you?
Every day. And it's miraculous, actually. So, and it started off just 5 days a week. Now it's every day. 7 days a week. Doesn't matter where we are.
Oh, that's awesome.
And so that's a part of it. And then the next phase.
That's at 5 a.m., right?
That's at 5 o'clock in the morning. I mean, sometimes we'll wax and wane.
Right.
You know.
Not like on Saturday and Sunday, too, 5 a.m., right?
Not at 5 a.m. on the weekend.
Okay. Okay.
But we do check in every weekend.
You're good. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, and if somebody's not checking in, we're like, what's going on? Mm-hmm. So we do that, and then I move into some kind of exercise, whether it's yoga. I discovered this guy on YouTube that I really like, so
Ooh.
I've been following. His name is Rick Bueller.
Okay.
He's amazing. He's like dancing, and it's just fun. And so I do him a lot. There's another young lady on YouTube, Elizabeth Ariana, I think her name is. She does yoga.
Mm-hmm.
So I just find somebody on YouTube that I follow, and I do 20 minutes.
Nice.
After that, I meditate for 20 minutes. And then I read a book or I listen to a podcast. More recently, I've started actually physically reading a book
mm-hmm.
because I like to read.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that, you know, it's easy to listen to the Audible book, and mm-hmm. you're on the go, and
yeah.
you're hearing something. Oh, I want to write that down, but you don't.
Yeah.
So I started reading, physically reading a book for 20 minutes in the morning.
That's awesome. It's kind of similar to what I do in my morning routine. And I want to touch on this because it's something that I'm really into right now. But that's the meditation. Do you mind sharing? Because I know it's personal for some and others. We're all about sharing here.
Sure.
But it's up to you. This is your safe space. And if you want to share what your meditation looks like, I'd love to hear it.
So that's a really good question, because and it's personal, and I'm going to tell you why. Because I grew up in a church environment where meditation was like, why are you doing that? Because that's not what we Christians do.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that was the mindset. So when anybody would talk to me about meditation, I'd be like, no, I can't do that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's like not the right thing to do, until I actually was invited to somebody's meditation studio. And I went, because she kept asking me, and I'm like, I gotta go, right? And I finally went, and it literally transformed my life
mm-hmm.
in that moment. I've never been the same since. So every day, my meditation varies. I do guided meditation.
Mm-hmm.
Deepak Chopra, Gabby Bernstein. I mean, there's countless people. There's Mindful Movement on YouTube.
Yeah.
And it's just 20 minutes of guided. And then sometimes as you, I think, advance in your meditation practice, you don't need so much somebody talking
yeah,
to you.
Yeah.
You can actually sit there in silence and just be with your own thoughts and just be still and quiet. There's so much value in the stillness.
Mm.
Like, we're so busy.
I'm smiling so hard right now, and I cannot, like, unscrew it, because it's so true. My meditation changed, and it continues to change my life, and it has ebbed and flowed and transformed into my own thing. And so when I ask, you know, do you mind sharing it, because I know it's personal, because I know what it means for me, and I know how it's advanced from just being this, like, guided thing that I would do to now I've advanced maybe to the next.
Yeah.
Not, I don't want to say there's levels, but I feel
for
more
yourself,
comfortable.
For your
journey.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm feeling like I'm advancing or progressing in my meditation, and it's just so amazing. It is the stillness,
yes,
that
it's just
makes,
like,
the difference.
I mean, our minds are going. It's like your work is going. Email, phone, like, it's
everything.
Constant. Social media, it's constant. So I was reading a book today. It's called The Essentialism, and it was talking about, like, factoring time just to think. And I'm like, what?
Yeah.
So it's not about meditating in that space. Mm-hmm. It's just thinking, not on your phone, not checking email, not answering your phone call, just thinking. Like, how many people can do that?
And that's what I was gonna make that really, that when you said about the time to think. It's new to me, and I'm trying to change my language. I've shared some things, like, where today is a perfect example. It is a rough morning,
mm-hmm.
and I text Jenna, and I was like, I need to send something positive. I need to change my mindset.
Sure.
Because I'm already seeing, you know, it's 8:30 or at this point, I think it was like 9:30 or 10 in the morning, and I was thinking of, like, okay, I know what today has in store. I know what I have to accomplish, and this mindset, it's negative. You know, I was late. I woke up late. I had all my ducks set in a row, and I just, like, put a splash in the water, and I sent it in another direction, right? So I sent, you know, I had this little book that I had gotten with positive affirmations to on a daily, and it was sitting in a bag still, and I just bought it maybe a couple days ago. Let me open it, put it on my desk, and that thought process of being mindful of just thinking of how I think, you know, setting that time aside for the 10 minutes that it took me to read it, do, you know, come up with the process, send mm-hmm. something, it does make a huge difference. And I think the idea becomes more and more shift, you know, my mindset is starting to shift in the sense where I wasn't a morning person. I would jokingly say, like, don't talk to me after 10. You've experienced some of that before, where I'm just like, like, you're like at 6 a.m. and I'm like, no.
You're like, I'm ready to go.
She's just like, great, because I'm on, like, my third cup of coffee. You're on my second task of the day and my third workout, and I'm like, I'm on my last dream. Give me a second. But it's true, and I noticed that, like, I do want to get more things accomplished. So just the fact that I love the idea of just, like, what you said, of just, you know.
But here's the beauty of what you said, is that you are aware.
Yeah.
So the awareness is where you start to change, because people can say negative things and feel bad and their day spinning out of control, and they let it spin,
mm-hmm.
right? But you had an awareness to stop it,
mm-hmm.
and you exercise a tool, you text somebody who's a positive person, and
yeah.
you read the affirmations or whatever it is you did to change your frequency, your vibrations, whatever you want to call it,
right.
into a different focus. And then guess what happens?
Yeah.
You feel better.
Yeah. We're here.
So, you said a word that I think is coming up a lot lately, and it's not a new word. It's just more popular now. Awareness.
Mm.
Awareness is something that is important socially, in our own body, our thoughts, how we act. But how can we be more aware? If someone is like, how do I even get started on all this stuff?
You literally took that question. I was like, I'm going to say that. How does somebody even know that they're not aware?
Yeah, how do you start to be more aware?
Yeah.
So I think it's a great question, and I think it has a very simple answer.
Mm.
And my mentor told me this. He said, Marcia, sometimes you have to get mad. Mm. What? What do you mean get mad? It's an acronym. You have to make a decision. So very simple. You have to make a decision about how you want to be.
That's so
how
true.
You want to live, how you want to show up, And you might not know, like, how you're going to follow through on the decision. But the thing comes from in deciding. Deciding that you want to be different. Deciding that you want to be a morning person. Deciding that you want to be aware. It comes from a simple thing as making a decision. And then the journey begins. It's as simple as that, in my opinion.
Gosh.
Wow. Like, I think I overcomplicate it when I try to... Because I want to help as many people as I can. I think it's like my purpose. Calling. It's my calling to...
You're aware of that.
help people to live a more aware life where you're just like... I call it living between the lines. It's not just waking up, going to work out and to work and showing up and you're just checking the boxes. Like, I want to enjoy the whole process
of
it.
Of course.
I want to put my clothes on and love on my body. I want to... be excited about going to work out. I want to brush my teeth and be grateful for my teeth.
Yeah.
You know, just like the little things. And
you told me some things that reach out when you, especially in that realm that you're saying, you said, because you deserve, you mentioned it the other day, you're like, I clean out my car more frequently because I deserve to ride around in a clean car.
Yeah. Or
clean my house because I deserve to live in a clean house, you know, and it's true, right? Like, we make it, we can say, oh, I have to clean out my car because I haven't cleaned it out in 2 weeks and I have papers everywhere. And versus like, I deserve to clean my car out because I should ride around in a clean car.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean? Like, it's just this just different way of putting it out there. And, you know, it goes in. And that's why I think, you know, you mentioned it earlier. And I think that's why where accountability partners come into to play. But how do we find where can we start to find those, like, that accountability and before reaching, you know, not all of us are, or not everyone is looking for somebody or happens to know that that's going to be my accountability partner.
You know, I didn't know, like, when I started, like, we read a book together, it's called The 5 a.m. Club, and we just made a decision that, hey, let's put this into practice. Let's just try it and see. So that's a part of what I described as the 5 a.m. Club. And so that, through that, we're like, okay, well, how are we going to stay accountable? I think we should, like, call each other or text or something. Like, how am I going to get up at 5 o'clock in the morning? This is not what I do. This is not my jam, right? Mm-hmm. So when you lean on somebody else, they're able to pull you up when you are not feeling like doing it. Mm-hmm. And they're going to call you out on it because why? You've already said, this is what I want to do.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So I think because, you know, the universe conspires to help you, right?
Mm-hmm.
So when you put things out there, the universe does bring it back to you. God does bring it back to you. He shows you people and people start to, like, y'all too showed up in my life because I put something out there and I told God what I wanted and here I am sitting having this conversation with you.
The text messages that we sent when this happened, like, I think I sent them to Jenna. I was like, dude, I want to cry. You know, because and I think that you do start attracting that, and I've said it time and time again, you're one of them, and since then, and meeting Jenna and Mark and starting living the journey, I mean, we're blessed. We have conversations, and I think we even if it's over text, we'll text each other separately, and it's like, we're blessed.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? But you put it out there. You thought about it. You're mm-hmm. aware of what you're wanting to do.
And it comes back to you.
You keep putting it out there, right? It's just like a recycling bit.
And the Bible talks about, you know, you plant seeds,
mm-hmm,
right?
Mm-hmm.
So to me, you know, however you are spiritual, you're planting the seed of what you want.
Mm-hmm.
And to me, you got to speak about what you want, not the things that you don't want. My coach used to say to me, Marsha, you get what you deserve, not the things that you want. I'm like, okay.
And that's how you talk.
Just because you want it doesn't mean you can get
that's
it.
Right.
But do you deserve it?
Mm-hmm.
And then how are you going to show up to deserve what it is that you want? You got to show up differently. You can't just show up any kind of way. You got to be on your A game.
Yeah.
And being on your A game means getting up in the morning and spending some time with yourself.
That's
I believe
so
that. Next I want to ask if someone is looking for a mindset coach or mindset transformer, coaches too small. We're thinking big. We're thinking
right?
about transformation.
Right?
Absolutely.
How can they get a hold of you? Are you doing one-on-one sessions? Like, walk me through what it looks
process,
like to be your client.
Yeah. So, you know, that's been an evolution also. So my forte is one-on-one clients.
Mm-hmm.
But I know that there are some people that may not feel comfortable in a one-on-one conversation because they don't know me. I think I'm pretty easy to talk to, but
yes, so aside you from
okay, aside from that, so one-on-one, and I go through like a 12-week curriculum with my clients, and even though it's I have a curriculum, it is kind of custom to the individual. So depending on how CJ shows up today and depending on our conversation will kind of let me know how we need to proceed. Mm-hmm. But I do have a curriculum that I follow. Mm-hmm. Outside of that, I am in the process of developing a group coaching program. Mm-hmm. And so it's going to be a little bit more affordable for some people. And then there's that sense of community that you can have there. And if you're like just super shy and like, I'm not sure I can talk to her yet, just follow me on Facebook because I go live every Tuesday.
I love that.
Oh, you do? Yeah. That's cool. Okay. I need to start following you.
Yeah, you get a sense of who I am and how I speak. And then, you know, before you know it, you feel like you're my friend.
Yeah. I can attest to that. It's weird, you know, because, not weird, but you don't know, we've said this in a previous conversation, but, and I say it often because I realize I don't know a lot. You don't know what you don't know, right?
Sure.
And you don't know what you need either sometimes. You don't know what you're missing until you hear it. Or you know, I've chimed in on a couple of morning your check-ins and on Facebook. And even, you know, they're there all day. And I've gotten interrupted a couple times. And it's weird because it'll come back. And it'll be like almost at the same place. And I pick up to continue watching. And you're one of the people that I believe what you say.
Oh,
right?
Thank you.
And I think that comes from the fact that you say what you mean. You know what I mean? And you can't help but it's the same like our conversations. It's just like you get sucked into these conversations because they're coming from an authentic place, right? Mm-hmm. And I don't think that's something that all of us are comfortable doing. It's been a work in progress. And literally, like, I can say that maybe I've shut off a layer or two, but through living the journey, through having conversations, through meeting impactful people like yourself, like Jenna, I know that I'm hungry for it, and I know others that I just see it where I'm like, I know you're in a similar spot. You know, how can we encourage that with other people? How can we encourage people to realize that maybe they need to change their mindset? You know what I'm saying? Not because I want to call somebody out and say you're a negative person,
right?
You know, but just you want to
help
them
in a loving way.
Yeah, like what if you just thought about that differently, right? But it's different when you're wanting to tell your friend or a family member or somebody that you care about because it can come off negative.
Yeah, so, you know, my big thing is to give people space and grace. Mm-hmm. Like, that's the thing I tell people. Give yourself some space, give yourself some grace, and pace yourself on this journey because it doesn't happen overnight. Mm-hmm. So even for myself, being the positive Zen person that I am now, I wasn't always this way. Mm-hmm. I was actually a very negative person with no confidence. Like, talk to strangers? Not happening.
Tell us
be
about
live?
That.
Yeah. No way. That's not me. Anybody who knows me would say, no, that was not Marcia. So my point to saying that is because I've invested a lot of time, energy, money to become this person. Mm-hmm. And I think that when somebody wants to change, so you might want them to change, you might want to change for your friend, but if they don't want it, there's nothing you can do about it.
Yeah, that. When you were asking the question, I was like, someone's got to want to change.
Yeah.
You know, we cannot, and you're the expert here. I'm not trying to speak out of line, but I just think that if you want to change, it has to come from you. I can't say, CJ,
right,
you're lacking in this department.
Right.
You might want to check your mindset because it's really an internal, personal thing. And you'll know. Like, I think people just know when, like you, you're...
I mean, you can say it to CJ, but is CJ going to be at a place to receive it?
Right.
And that's what I guess that's kind of what I mean, because it's kind of like, for instance, like, if I know that I want to lose 10 pounds, I probably should do some sort of diet, right? And you can suggest something to me, but I need to want to do that specific diet. Mm-hmm. I need to want to do keto, or I need to want to do, you know, whatever diet or whatever the case is, because it fits. It's what I need right now. It's going to fit my need for whatever. And I think that's where I'm saying is, or I guess, you know, in a roundabout way, if somebody doesn't know what they need, how can you, you know, is there kind of a referral thing that you talk to
I mean, you can
an expert, or
you can refer a client. Like, mm-hmm. I had somebody this week send me a message, I have a friend, blah blah blah, and I'm like, great, but kind of needs to be the friend.
Yeah. And I was saying, like, I would guess, like, that would be the response. I'm like, man, if I want to tell somebody, you know.
Yeah, it kind of needs to be the friend. But to your point, like, when you're talking about different diets and whatnot, mm-hmm. like, it goes a little deeper than, you know, your food choices.
Absolutely, yeah.
Right? It's like, I want to live a healthy lifestyle. Mm-hmm. Why? Mm-hmm. You got to dig deeper into why you want to do those things so that you are more inclined to stick to it. So it's digging deeper than, you know, just the mindset, if you will, or I want to be positive. It's like, really, why? Mm-hmm. Like, why do you want to do this? Mm-hmm. Why do you want to mm-hmm. be this way?
Intention, that, would you say?
Exactly.
Yeah.
We love that.
Yeah. We use that word like 10 times a day.
Yeah.
Every day. Yeah, yeah. It's awesome. I think that that's where it starts, is with intention. And when your intention is from a really deep place, that's where the magic happens. Absolutely. Another word I use a lot, magic.
But it is magical.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, the transformation that I've experienced is magical. And just sitting here talking to you, it's magical, you know. But again, you have to want it. Like, I want it. So I look for opportunities mm-hmm. where I can share, where I can speak, where I can, you know, shed light or whatever, motivate or inspire. I look for those opportunities because they inspire me.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Like, being here with y'all inspires me.
Oh, I'm extremely inspired right
you.
Now.
Thank you.
That's
humbling.
I'm extremely inspired by you.
Coming
right
from you, yeah, that's huge.
That is huge. And I think, you know, for what you mentioned, you were shy and you didn't have confidence to talk on, to do live or to do interviews or any of this stuff. What was a turning point for you? What made you say, okay, I can step out and try?
So, good question. That question came up like a couple weeks ago. Mm-hmm. I'm in the process. I don't think I shared this with y'all.
Yeah, okay.
I'm in the process of writing a chapter for a book that's going to be published this year.
Whoa.
Oh, yeah.
No,
that's a big deal.
Yeah.
By the way.
Yeah. I'm writing a chapter in a book.
And so the publisher, so I wrote the first draft and we're like, okay, we need to rethink and redo and it's fine. And as a part of that, though, I've been extremely self-reflective.
Mm.
And I remember when I said to myself, I was probably about 18, I can't live like this anymore. I didn't know how I was going to change, though. I was so shy. I was so reserved. I was so quiet. And I just felt like my whole life was passing me by and I was not participating.
Mm.
And I felt like I wasn't going to have experiences because I was so, like, petrified with fear and just quiet. And so even then, I didn't know how I was going to change, but I believe I planted the seed way back then. It took a while for the seed to germinate.
Yeah.
I'm not going to lie. It took a long time. It took me moving to the United States and, you know, being exposed to different things. But always in the back of my mind is I knew that there was something more. There was something more within that had to come up out of me. I didn't know how. And then, you know, life happens and I figured my path.
So plant your seeds.
Plant your seeds, most definitely.
And you mentioned the age of 18. Can people maybe start planting their seeds, I don't know, at the age of 33?
Of course!
You know what I mean? Like,
it's never too late!
And I think sometimes we do think about things like that where, like, man, how do I change? Because I've told this to Jen, and sometimes I feel silly saying it because I don't know much else other to say. Like, I know there's something...
Greatness lies within.
You know there's something there, but I just don't know what or how or what it's going to manifest into, but it's there, you know? And I think the conversations like this where you encourage people, I guess just say it, right? You know, and put it out there and you know, create a safe space. And that was kind of what the basis of this was, maybe as a starting point. But hearing someone that has educated themselves and experienced that and sharing that light with others, you know, Jenna shares it with me all the time, and she really is a lot of probably coaching without even realizing that she's doing it. But
I'll send you the bill.
Yeah.
You better be ready. Because she's good, I can tell.
Or no, you hear those things and you know, the things that you're saying are resonating, you know what I mean? And I think that's why the when I say even over text message, just the timing and the crossing of paths and having certain conversations are bigger than us. And
yes, they are.
It is happening for a reason. But I love that you're here and you're available to offer that to other people in the valley and anywhere.
Yeah.
You know, anywhere. And I think that that's just such a powerful gift to have. So I'm just humbled that you're here and we're having this conversation. But what are the things that you would like to leave, like, our guests or our audience with as far as being able to start that process if they're ready to reset and change their mind or change their mindset?
I think, as I mentioned before, make a decision. Mm-hmm. Just flat out decide. And then the next thing I would say is that you want to set yourself up for success, so follow through becomes inevitable. So, for example, if you are going to start a morning routine and you're going to work out as part of your morning routine, you got to have your gym clothes ready. Like, you kind of need to know that. Like, plan ahead. Mm-hmm. It's something simple. Like, don't have your tennies in the closet. Put them out by your bedside. Mm-hmm. Right? So, set yourself up for success. So, follow through is inevitable. You get out of bed, your tennis shoes are there, you're going to put them on. Right? Something very simple. But I think it's practical. Mm-hmm. Right? And then the next thing I believe is that I don't think we're kind enough to ourselves. Mm-hmm. You know, yeah. We've been through a crazy year with all kinds of stuff happening in our world, and we're not kind enough to ourselves first. I believe in being kind to one another, of course, but you have to be kind to yourself first.
That's so important.
And if you
remind ourselves of that.
No, like, and if you're not kind to you, then how can I be kind to you?
Yeah.
Right? So I'm very nice to me mm-hmm. all the time. Mm-hmm. That's how I start my day. I pour into me first so that I can be able to pour into other people. So I'm not, like, tapped out at the end of the day.
And I think it's great that you as a mom is saying that, because I'm pretty sure a lot of moms feel that they have to take care of everyone else first. Mm-hmm. And I'm not a mom, so I can't speak to it, but coming from you, it's probably comforting to hear.
It's like a game changer. As a mother, I have to take care of me first. And I know that's hard for mothers to understand, especially when you got little ones. I mean, my kids are 11 and 15, so they're not so little, but I do remember the days of feeling like I'm drowning, mm-hmm. you know, very overwhelmed. But what I've come to recognize is that if you just take 30 minutes, if you can't take a full hour, just take 30 minutes, take 15. And exercise some self-compassion and kindness to you at the beginning of the day, it changes everything. Mm-hmm. And even in the middle of the day, when you feel like it's spinning a little bit, stop and show yourself some compassion. Mm.
Mm. It's the oxygen mask analogy?
Yes, you exactly.
You gotta mm-hmm. put yours on first if mm-hmm. you wanna help others.
Yes.
You know,
and sometimes you might need that oxygen mask a few times during the day, and it's okay, grab it, put it on, so that you can be of service to other people. Your children, your husband, your employees, your coworkers. It's so very important.
And for somebody that balances, that juggles all that, you're talking firsthand, you know.
100%. Life.
You're founder of a nonprofit organization. You run a clinic, a physical therapy clinic. I mean, I just think you deal with all sorts of individuals, and then your clients, right? Where do you personally find the energy to?
It's in my morning routine.
It's in your morning routine.
It really is. It is in me getting up and exercising and having fun with it and not being too serious about life, because there's so many serious things happening in life. And just being happy with who I am in my skin. Mm-hmm. Like, just finding that joy within is just so valuable, and it doesn't take much. You know, maybe you're not, you know, spiritual. Listen to something on YouTube that's motivational. Like, that's how you start. It's very simple things, and then you graduate to conversations, to books, or whatnot. You know, it's just, I think it's the little things that we do that definitely can just change everything, but you have to be very intentional.
Mm. Very intentional.
And aware.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And I think once you start looking for all the tools, they just start...
They start coming to you.
They just start coming, and you don't have to do all of them. You can do some of them. If someone introduces you to something, you can try it, and if you didn't like how it felt, it's okay. You know, you tried it, discard, try something else.
Right.
Keep what feels good, discard what doesn't. So I think, yeah, once you start being more aware, you'll start seeing all of these tools come your way. It's amazing.
Yeah,
you're amazing.
Oh,
yeah,
thank you.
Amazing.
But you guys are too. You guys have the podcast. I know.
I want to put that out there. I, I know I am now. And I can say it comfortably, and you all should tell yourself that.
Yes, and there's no shame in that.
No,
like, it's not an arrogance thing, because people think that, oh, I can't say that. It's not about you being arrogant. It's about being comfortable with who you are and just really letting people see that. Like, I know that about me now. I'm very comfortable in my skin. And I know that when you look at me, you're like, she looks comfortable. Because I say it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And but that's what the energy that I exude to other people. So.
Which we can feel.
Yeah,
we absolutely. Can totally feel it.
And I want everybody to be able to feel that as well. Can you just tell everybody real quick where they can find you on social media or the best way to contact you?
Yeah, so...
And share it when this airs as well.
So. Awesome. So you can find me on my website, MarshaTerry.com. I have a contact us. You can send me a message there. Follow me on Facebook. That's where I live. I know I should be living on Instagram. I'm trying to make the transition.
I'm sure some building partner's probably telling you, at least frowning right now.
I'm there, but not as much as I need to be. But I do respond to my messages on Instagram at The Mindset Transformer. But Marsha Terry on Facebook is where I am.
Awesome.
For the most part.
Thank you so much.
Thank you
for having us and for gracing us with your magic and putting us in a different mindset, you know?
Awesome.
And it's contagious, and you have a beautiful gift, and we thank you for joining and
thank
sharing
you.
That with us.
I feel so honored.
Thank you guys for tuning in. We appreciate you guys continuing to follow us and continuing to support us. If you're not already, if you're new to this and this is the first time that you're seeing our episodes, you can follow us on Facebook, on Instagram, and on YouTube at Living the Journey RGV. Thank you so much, and we'll see you guys soon. Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye, everyone.